Look into the unknown. Experience a hidden world. Night, as you've never seen it before. Light enhancing and heat-seeking cameras penetrate the pitch black to give us the best view we have ever had. Witness lions in action when they are most active. Watch as they use darkness to their advantage and change your view of lions forever. Explore with us the Night of the Lion. Night is when lions start their day. And to follow them, we need to work in their time zone. What you are watching is filmed in almost complete darkness. This is hunting as you've never seen it before. Now you can see that at night, lions don't wait for prey to come within range. They go after it. In the darkness, they locate victims by scent and sound. To the prey animals, the lions are invisible. The lions only use their eyes at the last moment when they lock onto a target. You have just witnessed a typical night hunt, as executed by three killers acting in cooperation, and their tag-along male. These images are only possible thanks to amazing new night filming technology.
Can you see the crossing yet, Tom? It's around here somewhere, I can't see it yet.
Most lion activity occurs at night. But until now, we've only been able to record the tiny fraction they get up to by day. Our challenge is to tell the whole story. Previously, we had to use spotlights. Their powerful beams permitted us to follow the animals, but the strong illumination also allowed the animals to see each other. We altered the very behavior we were trying to film. Yet without light, conventional cameras can see nothing, even under the brightest of moons. But now, we have the means to see into the darkness. 15 years of development have led to a camera built specially to show the night world in detail, the Starlight camera. To this camera, moonlight is as bright as the sun. The night-adapted eyes of both predators and prey can see as far as we can in daylight. But this light level is only 1/100,000th as bright. Humans need night vision goggles to drive in this darkness. The problem is, brilliant moonlit nights like this occur only a few times in each month.
Just go straight ahead there. Oh!
Most nights are much darker, lit only by stars. Human eyes have real difficulty perceiving much at all. Incredibly, the Starlight camera can reveal this hidden world. It's so dark, baboons with eyes like ours can only spend the night in trees because they can't see their predators. But we can.
Did you get that?
Yeah, I got it. Let's go.
Sometimes a thick layer of cloud hides even the stars, and there's no light at all. That requires additional cameras and equipment. In this blackness, night vision goggles will only function with infrared light.
Take it easy, just turn to the left now.
The infrared beams are invisible to predators and prey, Our infrared camera allows us to observe how the dark leaves the animals almost blind. Yet when the action moves into the distance, even powerful infrared lighting can't reach. But we can follow the action further. With this, a new high-resolution thermal imaging camera. It detects heat from animals' bodies, alive or recently deceased. With our thermal camera, we can now follow animals in action up to an astonishing 8 kilometers away. No filmmaker or scientist has ever recorded this unprecedented view of the natural world at night. Armed with these 3 revealing cameras, starlight, infrared, and thermal, we can now witness the most action-filled hours in the lives of lions and follow them, night and day. For much of the daytime, lions endure heat and harsh sunlight. Dusk comes as a welcome relief. As the heat subsides, the cubs are up and ready to play. At just 4 months old, they're beginning to explore the world. To become successful adults, they'll have to learn to hunt. They practice the moves they'll need later in life, moves their mothers will use tonight. Most lions prefer to hunt in darkness. As night falls, we'd usually have to leave them, at the very time that this family, like almost every other pride in Africa, is preparing to move off. Now we can travel with them, all night, if necessary. Our vehicles are like deep ocean rovers, exploring a mysterious world.
Are you ready yet, Richard?
Yeah, just give me a second.
We see that in real darkness, without a moon, the grazing animals settle down, rest, and chew their cuds. It may not look like it. These lions are hunting. On this starry night, the pair can't see other animals more than 60 meters away. They are locating prey by scent and sound alone. Listening, smelling, learning about what is happening around them, picking up the news. Their sense of smell is many times better than ours. At night, noises travel much further in the cool, dense air, and the lions recognize the slightest sound. Unlike by day, prey isn't coming to them at a waterhole. If they want to catch more than a mouse, the lions must walk to find dinner, many hours if need be. The lionesses give a signal and the cubs stay put. These cubs are too young and vulnerable to follow. The cloak of darkness lets the two hunters move into the open without being seen. They'll need to be quick. Soon, the rising moon will reveal the lions to their prey. Their senses are alert. The sound of grass being uprooted indicates grazing animals nearby. Scent on the breeze gives the lioness an idea of how many animals are there and what kind. Wildebeest, impala, and topi are all potential meals. These two are a well-honed team. One is normally a chaser, and the other usually does the catching. but the paper-dry grass makes it difficult for the lionesses to move without a sound. The grazers are listening out for the slightest rustle. Now there is a lion on either side of the unsuspecting herd. And the chaser sets things in motion. Her heavy footsteps flush the herd towards the catcher. The chaser can hear the desperate bleat of the topi. She heads towards the sounds of a struggle. The catcher squeezes the topi's windpipe in a death grip. In the darkness, the cubs can hear that their mothers have made a kill. But they won't move until they're called. The lionesses make their kill just in time. The rising moon is flooding the landscape. Lions wouldn't be able to hunt now. The bright light reveals their presence. Cubs gain an anatomy lesson. They smell, touch, and learn to recognize a topi. They can practice killing moves they'll need later in life. At this age, playing with their food is a valuable part of their education. It'll be a while yet before their mothers will let them near a hunt. In the meantime, they supplement their meat with some milk before bed. Adult lions find the heat of the day uncomfortable. They keep to the shade to stay cool and out of sight. For curious cubs, daylight can often be frustrating. While their mother sleeps, all they can do is watch animals, but they can't chase. As the sun sets, Mom gets up and prepares for a long walk. The nearest prey could be hours away. Her cubs are 10 months old now, big enough to keep up, and this family has hundreds of square kilometers at their disposal. For the cub's mother, the night's work is just beginning.
That is the moon, brother. Oh, yeah, awesome.
Even with such a bright moon, nocturnal lion behavior was almost impossible to film. Now, with the starlight camera, we can share their world. Lions walk quickly and easily. These cubs are being taken out on a tour of their range. They may have to travel 9 or 10 kilometers to find animals they can hunt. Our challenge is to follow the lions without losing them. Using the thermal camera, we can keep track of them better than by day. Intense moonlight bathes the landscape. And at night, Kat's eyes can see 6 times further than ours. Probably almost as well as the Starlight camera. The family arrives at a small herd of oryx. These cubs have barely begun to find out which animals they can eat or even what they look like. They approach to get a better view. This could be their first chance of some real action. The antelope are almost as curious as the cubs. The mother knows the cubs are distracting the oryx. She quietly lies down out of sight. The antelope are confident. The bright moonlight gives them a clear view of the lions. To the oryx, the cubs don't appear to be hunting in any way. The curious youngsters follow as the oryx move off. Only the thermal camera can see the hidden lioness. The big male oryx shows the cubs how very fit he is with his trotting gait. He's letting them know that they wouldn't be able to catch him. But he's not aware of the lioness concealed in the grass. In the bright moonlight, the oryx sees the lioness burst from her hiding place and runs for his life. The lioness has a top speed of 80 kilometers an hour, but she can only sustain it for a few seconds, unlike the oryx. The cubs, of course, saw this. At least they can now identify oryx as potential prey. It'll be a while yet before they have the other skills necessary to complete a hunt. Bright moonlit nights are the exception. With no moon, clear nights are lit faintly by stars. Then, the light level is only 1/20 millionth of daylight. Many animals compensate for this with a reflective layer in their eyes. It shows up with our infrared camera. Without infrared, the raw image from the Starlight camera becomes very grainy. Enhancing the camera's image gives us an idea of what the lion might be able to see in starlight, as her brain enhances her own vision in a similar way. But the light levels don't affect the thermal camera at all. We can see clearly, whatever happens. On nights like these, the herds often congregate on the tops of hills. And here they can be hard to find, especially in this darkness. But this lioness knows her area well. Tonight's hunt would normally be straightforward, except that she has some hangers-on. Her cubs. 14 months old, they already look adult. But can they hunt? Mom hangs back, perhaps hoping they'll get their own dinner for once. The sound of a herd of wildebeest attracts the cubs. The wildebeest are nervous. They can't see far in this gloom. The lion's lower viewpoint gives them a crucial advantage. In starlight, they can see the wildebeest silhouetted against the sky. One of the girl cubs can't resist making a move. Her brother joins her. This is a good start. Close the gap and wait for the best moment to strike. But another sister still needs to learn the value of patience. The wildebeest hear her heavy footfalls and take off. The young girl seems surprised to have cleared the area. Mum is not impressed. Now they'll all have to walk another half an hour before they catch up with food again. It's a painful lesson in wasted energy. Mum instructs her inept offspring to stay back this time, while she gets them all a good meal. She walks across the breeze to pick up the scent of the herd. As soon as she catches their smell, she turns towards them, into the wind. The starlight camera can just make the herd out. She can't see them yet. They still can't see her. Only now is she close enough to see her prey. She approaches with care, unlike the clumsy cubs. The wildebeest relax, unsuspecting. To the lioness, the wildebeest are silhouettes against the stars. But to the wildebeest, 60 meters away, she is completely invisible. We can only see her with the aid of infrared light, or with the thermal camera. The wildebeest have no idea what's about to happen. The chase is over in seconds. She may have selected a weak-looking victim, or in the confusion, simply tripped the nearest. Either way, she shows how one experienced lioness on her own keeps six hangers-on well-fed. The cubs know something's up by the drumming of hooves. Mum must have made a kill. She usually does. They just need to home in on the sounds of scuffling. When the youngsters arrive, Mum is still throttling the wildebeest. They betray their immaturity by merely playing with it before they start to feed. Now that they're fully weaned, they'll demolish it in half an hour. These youngsters are beginning to know their prey, but they'll need to watch their mum carefully in future. She won't always be there to bail them out. Let's hope in time these cubs can emulate their mother's skill. After a long sleep, of course. At around 2 years old, these young lions look as if they should be able to feed themselves. They have the bodies and bulk of hunters, but have they the brains and experience to be any good? They seem more like playful hooligans. But soon this bunch of hooligans will be forced to strike out on their own, ready or not. Their mothers are pregnant again. When the new cubs are born, there'll be no room in this pride for these big brothers and sisters. Little time remains for the mothers to ensure their offspring have the skills to survive. With night vision cameras, we can follow the next stages of their education. During the four nights around the full moon, there is very little true darkness. The blazing moonlight drowns out the faint glow of the stars. The starlight camera can see clearly, but so can the animals. The herds spread out and settle down. The young lions are ready for some action. They beg their mother to take them hunting. But she's in a very bad mood. She's pregnant and doesn't want to waste energy hunting in the glare of the moon. With such short grass, the big cubs are visible from a great distance. They need to learn that if the prey can see them, their chances of success are slim. The mother leaves her cubs to their own devices. The hooligans are desperate for something to creep up on. The lions are not the only hunters about tonight. Endurance hunters, like hyenas, chase their prey to exhaustion. They don't care if the wildebeest can see them. The moon lets the hyenas more easily assess the animal they're chasing. But the adult lionesses can see what the hyenas are up to. And stealing from hyenas is a regular source of food for lions. The kids follow the mums to where the action is. The hyenas run a wildebeest to exhaustion. Now the lions move in. Yeah. One of the mothers sees a chance to give the cubs some crucial experience. The wildebeest is too tired to flee. But the cubs are slow on the uptake. The mother still has to grab the wildebeest. At last, the most adventurous cub takes hold. Her mother immediately stands back. She gives her daughter the chance to make a kill big enough to feed the whole pride. The young lioness throttles her victim, just as she's been practicing on every kill since she was little. This is a big moment in her life. A sign she has what it takes to be a successful hunter. Like her mother. But time is running out for all these cubs now. Shortly, they'll be on their own. And sooner than they expect. The bright, moonlit nights are soon over. Pitch black darkness returns.
Can you see where we are, Tom?
Most lion activity happens at night, not just hunting. The starlight and thermal cameras allow us to capture a pivotal moment in these youngsters' lives, their transition to adulthood. New, helpless cubs are on the scene, and family priorities are changing. The hooligans are in for a real shock. Tonight, the lack of moon encourages the foolish youths to pick on a group of large male buffalo, normally a no-no. They risk gouging horns and trampling hooves. They do at least have the advantage of invisibility. Although without their dads, they won't have the power to bring down one of these bulls on their own. But buffalo killing is not on the agenda tonight. The pride can no longer tolerate these hapless youngsters chasing all the prey away. Now one of the brothers is taking an unhealthy interest in his sister. The mothers are losing patience. The big male calls his brother to back him up. It's crunch time. The two dads make it clear the youngsters are no longer welcome. Lightweights are not going to argue with 250 kilos of teeth and muscle. The hooligans' time in this pride is over, and the toughest days of their lives begin. They'll need to get their hunting skills together soon, or they'll starve to death. The next day finds this gang of youngsters, for the first time in their lives, directionless. They've been evicted from the pride. Without their moms, they aren't sure what to do next. Tonight, there's no moon, and there are plenty of animals around. Under cover of true darkness, it should be easy for these novices to make a kill. A Pride's experienced lionesses normally lead the hunt. They spread out, combining their forces and drive prey towards each other. But this wild bunch are all over the place. If only they would coordinate their attacks. That's the next lesson, to work with the other Pride members in the dark. They give their presence away before they are close enough to actually see their quarry. This looks more like how Mum did it. But she was patient. The eager young lioness goes too early, again. She doesn't wait to pinpoint her victim by sound. But she gets another chance with a herd of topi and their young. She runs down a tiny calf, and this time it pays off. It's a start. Finally, she catches something. This is a kill she can claim entirely as her own. She's passed her first test as an adult. But the meat won't be enough to feed the whole gang. At first, her brothers let her savor the kill. Then hunger gets the better of them. In a way, they are passing their first test, taking what they need by force. The huntress is left with nothing. For her and her sisters to survive, they need to get away from their greedy brothers. But there's no going back home now. The Pride already has enough adult lionesses. These cubs will have to find their own way in the wilderness. Before they had their cubs, these two lionesses endured at least a year on their own. They have not only learned to feed themselves, but a family as well, including the fathers of the cubs. In return for all the free meat they can take from the females, these two brutes deliver protection. But they're well worth it, keeping other lions and hyenas away and creating a safe haven for the cubs. The youngsters rush to meet their fathers. This may be the first time they've been allowed to get so close. They're fascinated. These two males have survived years on their own, carving out a territory. They're now expert hunters, as well as thieves and bullies. Exactly the kind of fathers these cubs need. Lions love gentle rain. The moisture cools them, ready for a night's hunt. Thick cloud conceals lions in utter darkness as they prepare to hunt. Even the ultra-sensitive Starlight camera struggles to capture meaningful images. But the thermal camera cuts through the dark to pick out the warm-blooded animals. The two mothers roar to warn others they'll be hunting on this patch tonight. It's now as dark as it ever gets on these plains. 1/200 millionth of the light levels of daylight. The zebras can't see the lions. And the lions can't see the limping zebra at the back of the herd. An injured animal would be a favorite prey item, if they could find it. The sound of the herd draws one of the lionesses closer. The limping zebra is falling behind. But tonight, the lioness would have to be within 6 meters to see it. Zebras are all around. Yet the zebras have no idea there is a predator in their midst. A 350-kilo zebra is a daunting prospect. A single kick could fracture a lioness's skull. She needs to pick her moment, carefully. The lioness hesitates, as though waiting for one victim in particular. Something catches her attention. This is where her years of experience count. She locks onto her target. Her claws couldn't get a grip on the zebra's wet hide. But following the sounds of the chase, her sister is there at the ready and grabs the stallion. Clearly, these two have mastered the art of teamwork. One lioness on her own could barely hold this muscular stallion down. Two together can finish him off quickly. Incredibly, the thermal camera reveals the bright, swollen front leg that belongs to that same limping zebra. It could be that's what they were after all along. They must have heard the irregular hoofbeats. This is a fascinating insight into how lions could select their prey, even without sight to guide them. Of course, all their effort serves one great purpose. The survival of their cubs. Night school begins again as a new generation meets their future. With the use of some extraordinary cameras, night filming reveals that lions are far from the lazy layabouts of daylight. They prove to be active experts in the wildlife around them, especially wildlife they can eat. For the first time, entirely without the aid of visible lights, we've been able to observe lions using all of their senses to turn the cloak of darkness to their advantage. We filmed them pass on the dark art of hunting from one generation to the next, and shown that night clearly is the time of the lion. Hello.